I think the most rewarding piece about teaching science is seeing that aha moment for a student. The main goal of Bite-Sized is thinking about what tools and resources we can provide teachers and educators. We have videos, and every video has supplementary curriculum. I just saw the power that food has in engaging students in science. And so then when I was here at the education school, all of the classes I took just continued to make me feel like there was something here.
Not only is it an engaging and deeply applicable idea, food, we eat it every day. Food is this incredible tool to help us translate the scientific concepts into practical, in the classroom, embodied learning experiences.
It's something that we all have experiences with, whether it's cooking and baking or just eating. We all bring something to the table. I think there's also already an inherent interest in it. I think capturing that interest and using it as a way to engage students in science, that's our goal.
So in my role, that's thinking about how we can infuse our curriculum with a concept like deep learning, having mastery, creativity, and identity embedded in our curriculum.
I think what I learned at the Harvard Graduate School of Education was giving me perspective in terms of both meeting people like Hallie, and then also there are a variety of professors that have really helped support me through this to make the best curriculum we can.
By incorporating food in a science classroom, you are able to translate what is known and help make sense of what is unknown in these scientific concepts.
I think that's where the kitchen really comes into play here, is like, what things can I do to learn more about how butter melts and browns, and then taking that experience and being curious about another. Kind of the key part of thinking like a scientist is just being really open and observing everything, and you never know where that might take you.